Hi, this is Ged Maheux from the Icon Factory, and today I'm going to walk you through creation of a custom graphic in Linea Sketch. This is going to cover a lot of ground, a lot of different kind of techniques, including selecting custom colors, using zip shapes, filling, using the pen tool, and grids. So let's get started. A while back, I found a few old retro graphics from Buck Rogers that I really loved online on the web, and I thought they would make neat avatars online, and so I wanted to clean them up, and I thought Linea was a good way to do that. And this is one example of one of them that I found. It was based off an old button that you used to be able to get, you know, if you were a kid. I guess in the 40s and 50s and 60s you could send away for Buck Rogers buttons and then join his secret elite club. So what we're going to do is I'm going to close out of this and I'm going to tap in my project and create a new sketch. And then under the templates, I'm going to select circular and select subdivided. And then next, I'm going to tap on the lowest layer here in Linea's five layers, and I'm going to select import and paste. And then I'm going to select Browse Files. And on my iCloud drive, I've set up a special folder just for things that I want to reference in Sketch and Linea. And I've got that here. It's called Linea Resources. So I'm going to select that. And then in here are all the different images I've collected that interest me. And the one that at the top, the Buck Rogers Club, is the one that I want. Now you can see it imports it in. It's too small right now, so we're going to size it up. And I'm just going to grab one of the corners and then the other corner and scale it down, and then I'm gonna reduce its opacity so I can see the grid a little bit better behind it. And then I'm gonna go back and rescale it a little bit more, get it right on the grid or close to the grid, something like that. And then I'm gonna accept that with a check mark at the top. So now I've got the artwork placed in Linea how I want, and now we need to go and collect some colors. So I'm going to turn this graphic all the way back up to 100%. And then if I go over to the color palette over here, and if I tap the little chip icon at the top, you can see all of them at one time. So the first set I have is set to vivid hues, and then the second one, let's select dark hues, and the third one is pastels. But we can also go down to custom colors here, and then we can choose any colors we want. So let's get rid of a few of these colors. I'm going to select the chip and then hit clear. Select the chip, and clear. And I don't need many colors for this drawing, maybe two or three. So I'm going to go back to the first chip and I'm going to select the eyedropper. And that's going to let me select the color that I want to use in the drawing for this blue. And I don't know, I think something there. That looks pretty good. And then I'm going to select the second clear chip, and I'll grab the eyedropper again, and I'm going to select this orange here. But I think I'm going to lighten that up a little bit. It's a little too dingy for me. So get it a little bit brighter, a little bit more saturated. Something like that. That's pretty good. So now I have my two main custom colors that I want. And I'm going to go back and I'm going to turn down the opacity of the graphic. And then I'm going to select not the layer right above the imported art layer, but the layer above that. That's the layer that we're going to use for outlining the artwork. And I mean, there's a couple different ways we can start this. One would be to draw those outer circles, and why don't we actually do that? I'm going to select that blue, and then I'm going to select the pen tool, and I think I'm going to go with not one of these thin ones, but I'll go with a medium thick line. So what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to zoom out a little bit, and then I'm going to just draw a real rough circle on the outside edge. And you do not have to be perfect with this at all, because Linea helps you do it. But all you do have to do is hold down at the end. And then we have a circle that we can adjust, make sure it's right on there on both sides. So that looks good. And I'm just going to tap and accept that. And now I'm going to do the same for the inner circle. And hold down at the end. And we can, again, size that circle as we want. Yeah, that looks good. And I'm going to accept that. So now if I toggle the artwork layer off, you can see that we've got the outer border circle for the artwork set. And I mean, we could fill that in. We could do all the hand lettering now. I think I'll leave that to the end probably. So what I will do is on another layer, I'll select the layer above the one we've been working on. And then we're going to go in and start actually outlining and inking the art. So where to start? It's really up to you, but I'm going to start up here and I'm selecting the largest of the small pen sizes, and I've got variable line weight, not fixed, but variable. And I'm not using semi-opacity on the ink. I'm using full opacity. I don't want to vary the opacity of the line as I draw. Yeah. And you might need to adjust the artwork opacity a little bit. When you do that, make sure you reselect the layer that you're working on. And I'm gonna something like that. Yeah, I don't like that, it's too thick. So I'm gonna redraw that. Pretty good. I'm gonna do, you can always do a two-finger tap to undo any stroke you just did. If you have shortcut set on your Apple Pencil, you can use that too. But I don't like to do that. I prefer using a two-finger tap. So I'm gonna try to do his eyebrows and his nose now. And I'm starting off with a little bit of pressure here because I want the tip of this line to be thinner than the rest of the stroke of the nose. See, I varied the pressure too much when I was doing that, so I'm going to do it again. And that's kind of what I wanted. It's a little uneven, so I'm just going to go back and restroke those places. And you can always use your finger to erase if you don't get it exactly how you want it. You know, I do that a lot. Yeah, I can't really see. The artwork is so low resolution that it's hard to see exactly what's going on there, but I think it's his lip like this. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Yep. And then I'm going to get his chin. Yeah, could be better. I'm going to do it again. It's a lot of trial and error to get shape sometimes when the curves change directions on you and things. It just takes practice, you know? It's like anything else. The more you practice it, the better you'll get at it. And again, if you don't like the line, you can always use your finger and go back and erase part of it. I do that a lot. So we'll turn the artwork off. You can see I'm starting to outline him. And we'll go in and do his eye. Yeah, that's pretty good. And then we're going to get his little space hoodie. Being able to rotate the canvas around at any angle so that your arm doesn't have to move in weird positions is really helpful. Now for his ear covering, I think what we'll do is we'll do another zip shape. So I'll draw a circle and hold. And then I'll adjust it down like that. And then I'll accept it. And then I'm going to erase part of it because it looks like it's not a complete circle. So I'm just going to go in and keep erasing back until I get it to where I want it. That's pretty good. You know? Yeah. I like that. We got all of these little rivets or something on his earmuff, so and I'm just varying the pressure as I draw these a little bit so I can get a little bit roundedness at the end compared to the middle. Yeah, that's pretty good. Now we have to draw the back of his head. This one's going to be tricky. I want to get it in one smooth line, but I don't know if we'll be able to do it. So we'll see. It's not bad, but it's uneven, but maybe we can erase. Yeah. Rethicken this up a little bit. Yeah, that's pretty good. I'm not going to draw that spaceship behind his head. I'm going to leave that off. I don't particularly like that part. So we're going to go down here and get his neck. Yep. And I'm going to get his collar. We can fill this part in here just by hand. I'm just going to color it in. But I'll show you in a little bit how we're going to use the fill tool to help speed things up a bit. So that, and I don't know what that is. I guess that's his back shoulder there. Yeah, looks about right. And we're going to get these collar. Yep. And then his front shoulder. See how much that line varies from end to end? It's so thin on the left and thick on the right. So again, we're going to push a little bit with the pencil over here and then a lot as we go. And we got it. A little bit, I varied a little bit as I went, so I'm just going to smooth it out. Yeah. And then I got these lines here. Yep. And then we'll just, I don't know, the shape is weird on the back of him, if it's the seat or his back of his back or what? I don't like that one. And connection. So let's turn off his artwork. That's looked pretty good. He needs all of his interior shading. We'll do that next. So we have all this cross hatching or hatching. The quickest way is to just simulate that. And it seems like there's some shading going on here. I want to try to keep that retro look to the whole thing. We could just fill it with a solid color, but then it wouldn't look like it was illustrated. So if we do it with hatching, we might need to switch to a thinner pen nib here. Yeah. And a little bit on the back side. I'm going to switch back to the thicker one for back here. And we're just going to and then we can fill in here. Like that. And as long as we have the shapes closed up like this, then we can, let's turn off the grid and turn off the background art, and we'll select the paint roller, and then we'll just tap in there. And then we can just fill in any spots it may have missed to clean it up like that. So it's a little bit quicker way of filling. And more hatching down here. Tough to see exactly what's going on, but we're just following those lines. You have to be sure to use the same technique, otherwise it won't look uniform when you're done. And we want it to look like, an old-timey illustration. So we really have to keep continuing on. Until we got it. These are like little rivets in his thing, so we're just gonna round those out a little. And then I'm gonna continue the shading behind the earmuff. Like that. Take a look at that. Yeah, that looks pretty good. And we got some in his neck back here. I'm just going to fill that in by hand. I'm gonna switch back to the thinner pen. And this shape, it's weird. And then under his chin, this looks like this is a solid shape. You know, sometimes you have to experiment to get the line shapes that you want. If you're not happy with one, just undo it and redo it, you know? It's easy enough. If this was real ink, you'd have to take your time and be a little bit more careful. And, you know, you get a little bit more purposeful with every stroke, but that's one of the beauties of digital illustration, is you have a forgiving nature with the undo. He's got a little bit of shading on his face. Pretty good. Needs a little bit more love in here. It's really a bolder shape back here. So we're going to fill that. And then get some hatching. Back there. That's pretty good. Yeah. Oh, get a little bit here. You don't have to fill in everything, of course, but I'm a stickler. Yeah, that's good. That's kind of retro-y down there. I like that a lot. So, we've got his main outlining done. And what we need to do now is we need to fill him with that orange. We need to get that checkerboard pattern in the back, and then we need to do the lettering. But what we're going to do is we're going to merge down these two layers that have the blue lines. One has the circle and one has his inking on him. So I'm going to tap on the top layer and then merge down. So now all the blue strokes are on one layer, which means I can select the layer underneath that. And then I'm going to select the orange that we selected earlier from the image. And I'm going to draw a line, a zip line, and hold, draw a line and hold on that layer at that boundary. And I'm going to do the same thing here on this edge here. Let me get that. There you go. And I'm going to position it like that. And then we're going to do this side here. So there we go there. And with that done, we should be able to fill those shape areas with orange pretty easily. So let's turn off the reference art, and then I'm going to go to the paint roller and try filling this. Yeah, that and that. And that worked great. And now we have to fill in his hoodie with that orange shape, with that orange color. So we can try this. We can use the fill tool, and we can just draw roughly to fill. I'm just drawing and I'm not letting up. Yep. And I'm going to do the same thing here and backtrace it around his ear and do that. And fill. And if you miss any spots, you can just lasso them and fill it. We'll worry about the ear after. So we're going to fill the rest of the back of his hoodie like that and like that. So now we have this extra shape. Hmm. Yep. What we can do is I can use my finger and I can just go in and erase. And that works. Yep. That looks like it's pretty good. And there's, I think, yeah, this down here, these areas are orange as well. So we can just use the paint roller and tap and tap. And this one's tricky because this orange area only covers the interior of the shape, not the entire shape. So I can't just tap and fill it. I'm going to have to select an area to fill, and that gets it. Yep. Now, if we want to get, you know, tricky about it or whatever, we can grab the eraser and erase back some parts of it just to stylize it a little bit more. Like, I'm going to erase some of these areas to create highlights. Could be doing this with my finger, but the Apple Pencil makes it a little bit more precise. So, you know, and then we get maybe a little bit of a highlight along the edge here of his hoodie strap. Yeah, that's pretty cool. And then along the top of his beanie nib, whatever the heck this is, I don't know what that is, but we'll erase some of that and give that a highlight up there. Yeah. And then maybe we'll even do that, some of that in here. Like, we can crosshatch highlighting. Yeah. That's pretty cool, you know? So, what's left to do? Well, it looks like it's the lettering. And we don't have a type tool in Linea. So, well, we've got to go and hand letter it, but it's pretty fun. You know, I enjoy it, especially in limited applications like this. So I'm going to select one of the empty layers at the top. And then I'm just going to, with the pen tool in non-variable width mode, we don't want line weights changing or anything like that. We're just going to outline the letters. It's not that hard, you know. It's just really patience. It's fun. It's like coloring by numbers. And I love typography anyway, so doing justice to these, because you know this type was hand lettered on the original button. I'm sure it was. It has that feel to it. Yeah. So, hand lettering it here feels like it's paying respect to the letter forms. And then we just fill in all this stuff. We can go and use the fill tool later, but if you want to fill in something once you go, you can do that. Save yourself time. Like if we do, you know, if I were to fill this right here, let's just do that. Close those shapes and then grab the fill tool and fill. And you can see how we're going to flush out that whole letter system. And, we'll skip forward because you don't need to see me doing the entire thing. So maybe I'll just fast forward this part and you can watch me letter, but we'll do it at super fast speed. Yeah. That'd be fun.
I wish I was a spaceman, the fastest guy alive. Fly you around the universe in fireball XL5. Way out in space together, conquers of the sky. My heart would be a fireball, a fireball. Every time I gazed into your starry eyes.
Okay, so now we have all of the letters outlined, and I'm going to fill in the in-between parts. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off the grid and the reference layer. And I'm going to actually move that outlining layer up one so we can see the lettering and inking for that. And then I'm going to actually fill on the layer below it. So that layer is empty, and I'm going to grab the paint roller, and I'm going to start clicking in the empty spaces. And by filling on the layer below it, it lets Linea fill more completely and you get less fringing going on. There'll still be some places where the shapes weren't connected that you'll have to fill in. But in general, I always try to fill on the layer underneath the outline whenever I can. It's a good little tip, you know. Yeah, that looks pretty good, you know. And if we wanted to, we could even change the color of the paper behind there. Let's choose like I don't know, let's say custom background, and then let's go and make it a little bit yellow, kind of like in the original graphic, you know? And we can turn the paper grain back on, and that's what we end up with. And it's pretty quick, actually. It went pretty fast, and it's fun. It's, you know, it's pretty cool to outline something and fill it and apply your own little artistic flair to it. So I hope this has been helpful, and you can go back and rewatch any part that had a part that you wanted to revisit and learn more about. That way, you know, you'll absorb it a little bit more, but hope to offer more of these tutorials in the future. Hope this was helpful, and thank you.